Hello, hello, hello! Hello, everybody! Hello, hello, hello! My name is Steve Ford, and I'm here once again with my dear student Leo in Brazil. How you doing, Leo?
Hello, Steve. Hello, everyone. I'm doing fine. Now I'm in São Luís, which is in the northeast of Brazil, the place where I was born.
That's awesome. I know that so far, having you as my guest student, that we've had you from São Paulo and also in Brasilia and now in São Luís. So, man, I mean, you travel.
Yeah, I mean, I do travel a little bit, but I enjoy that. It's fun.
Yeah, traveling is great. Traveling is great. There's nothing better than traveling to kind of have a different perspective on things. Mm-hmm. And I know that you travel a lot. And we want to say hello to everybody who is coming in. I know that, oh, wow, there are a lot of people coming in here. I'm going to try to figure out a way maybe to, I don't want to show us, but Leo, we have lots of Brazilians in the house. Yeah, we've got people from Iraq in the house. We've got people from Ribeirão Preto, São Paulo. We've got people from Brasilia in the house. Yeah, Brazil.
Wonderful.
In the house. India in the house. Anybody else in the house? So many. Dominican Republic in the house. Kurdistan in the house. Iraq in the house. Florianopolis in the house. Okay. Yes, is Florianopolis a country? Anyway. Okay. That's awesome. All right. So we have a lot of people in the house, and I just wanted to say that I have also invited some of my other students, but they are very shy to appear in a YouTube Live, which is fine. They're not comfortable with it, but Leo, he's the courageous one to appear in front of all these people on YouTube Live. So just to let you know that I have tried to invite some other students, so maybe they will come sometime. Mm-hmm. Yes. And okay, well, anyway, let's go into it. Leo, I know that you're kind of tight on time, as am I. I have a class in 26 minutes, so I don't have too much time on myself. So, Leo, we're going to continue the discussion, and everybody watching this lesson, we're going to continue the discussion about differences between North American culture, Canadian culture, American culture, and your country, your culture. Both Leo and
okay,
I...
let's do it.
Yeah, both you and I have lived in Canada, the United States, and also Brazil. Yeah, the only difference being I was born here and you were born in Brazil. So we might have slightly different experiences. So here's my first question for Leo and for everybody out there is, how do you call your girlfriend's or boyfriend's parents? And I have here by first name, like John, Mary, or by title, like Mr. Smith or Mrs. Smith, like, hello, Mr. Smith. Hello, Mrs. Smith. How are you today? The reason I ask is because I think it depends. And, you know, with some people, they're comfortable enough to call their girlfriend's mother Mary. You know, oh, hi, Mary. Like, that's okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Not in my day. In my day, it was Mrs. Smith or Mr. Smith. So it was a little...
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
In my opinion, I think overall, like, I think the first meeting, the first time you meet your parents, like your grand, your girlfriends or boyfriend parents, you'd say like Mr. or Miss, but after it's fine to call by first name.
So it would be okay the second time that you meet them,
yeah,
to be on like a first name basis.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Can I ask you a question? I mean, with your girlfriend now, we know that she's from another culture also. So
yes.
Do you call in your girlfriend's culture, like you've met your girlfriend's parents, do you call them by their first name now that you've known them for?
Yeah, but by their first name.
Okay, that's cool. So they're cool with that. Yeah. Yeah. you don't have to.
Yeah, after you know them for a couple of weeks or month, it's fine.
Okay, so yeah, it's not so formal nowadays. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. That's cool. Let's Leo. I'm just gonna check to see if any other people are mentioning some comments.
I'm curious about other people's opinion.
Yeah. And just so that everybody knows, Leo's girlfriend is can I say?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, Leo's girlfriend is, yes, girls, he has a girlfriend, sorry. Leo's girlfriend is Polish. So he's saying that after the second time meeting them, it's okay to call them, you know, what their names are, their first names. So like Eva and Adam, for example.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And okay, so I have one here, Dave Abraham. I don't know where Dave is from, but Dave is saying, I recommend Mr. and Mrs.
Forever?
Leo's asking if you would say Mr. and Mrs. Forever or just the first time. Yeah, we want to know, as everybody who's watching this video wants to know.
And where are you from, David?
Yeah, hey, Dave, where are you from? Yeah, you got to let us know where you're from. We have Mekrash Kamal. I will call him by his name, and I am from Algeria. So they're saying in Algeria they would say first name. So you're on a first name basis. Okay. So same kind of idea. Okay. And let's see if I have any other. Oh, Fernando O Claudio from Brazil would call his the parents of his girlfriend my beautiful snake. Is that like a Brazilian inside joke or something like that? My beautiful snake.
Maybe, yeah. There are some jokes about the mother-in-law.
Oh, yeah. We have some jokes. Mateus Leonardo, also from Brazil, is saying he would call them by their first name. And so I think most people said that it would be by the first name. Yeah.
Yeah. You know, I was born here in northeast of Brazil. I'm not sure if that's like a northeastern thing or the whole Brazil, but we call our parents-in-law like with aunt and uncle in the name for some reason.
Would you say, you would say tia? You would say aunt and uncle?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
And I haven't seen that in São Paulo or in other south states.
Yeah. Okay. Then I think I have Dave. Oh, Dave Abraham is saying, you don't remember me? Dave Abraham, that guy that gave that answer, Mr. and Mrs., he's from Kurdistan. So in the Middle
great.
East. So I guess it's more formal. Yeah.
I just came. Well, I was in Dubai in March. It was really fun.
Okay, cool. Okay. And then I have Khadija. Khadija is saying, in my culture, it isn't polite to call older people by their first name.
Mm.
So I guess that would include the parents of your girlfriend, boyfriend. Okay. I have Parvana Valizada. In our country, we call uncle and aunt in Azerbaijan, just like in Brazil, in your region.
See?
That's cool.
It's not only here.
No. Yeah. Okay. So, and Dave is, and don't you remember me, Steve? Yeah, forever, of course, because I think it's more polite. Yeah, so he's saying, the guy from Kurdistan, Dave, is saying that it's more polite to say Mr. Mm-hmm. Mrs. Okay, so let's go on to the next one. I know that we could be here for like 5 hours, but we got to keep this short. Other people are going to be watching a recording of this. I have to remember to talk more slowly. Okay, so here's the next one, Leo. In North America, it's possible to call in-laws mom and dad. And I don't know if you knew this, but...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
No, I didn't know that. It's, maybe uncle and aunt will be fine, but not mom and dad.
Yeah, so if they're your in-laws, yeah? So sogros, your in-laws... after you get married, it's common, I would say 50% of the time, especially from my generation. So when my Brazilian wife arrived here in Canada, she had to call my mother and father, mom and dad. And that was extremely strange for her.
Yes.
Because
I can understand her.
Right? Because Brazilians, they only have one mom and dad, right?
Yeah.
And then suddenly she has like two moms and two dads, you know, it was really strange for her. And on top of that, because of her pronunciation in English, she was very afraid of saying dad incorrectly. And she was afraid that dad would sound like dead.
Mm-hmm.
And my dad's name is Doug.
Okay.
Douglas. And so she was afraid of saying dad or Doug. She was afraid of saying dead dog, you know, like a you know, dead dog, you know, instead of dad or Doug. So that was one thing. Anyway, here's the next one here. If you're eating at your mom and dad's house, would they say, Leo, please pass the salt? B, Leo, pass the salt. C, hey, pass the salt. What would they say?
Yeah, I think a letter A or so. Yeah.
So your parents would say, please pass the salt, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's get some. So would mine. Mine would say, please pass the salt. My wife was a little surprised the first time when she came to Canada and we were all sitting at the table and my mom says to me, Steve, can you please pass the salt? And Leda's like, wow, the mother or the father says please to their children, to their child. She was a little surprised. Let's get some feedback from some of the other people watching this video. A lot of people are saying please, that Mateus Leonardo is saying B, that it would be just pass the salt. But most people are saying that it would be please. Okay. Yes. Anyway, okay, so we'll go to the next one. I know that probably we'll get more answers coming in, but we don't have that much time. They're saying in Dominican Republic, what was that? In Dominican Republic, oh, that's a reminder that I have a class in 15 minutes. In Dominican Republic, mom or dad says, hey, pass the salt. How do you say that in Spanish? Like, oh, pásala. I don't know. We just didn't...
Oh, sal.
Yeah, sal. Pasa la sal. Yeah. Arriba, arriba. Andale, andale. okay. Dave Abraham is saying, beyond C, ha, 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 heavy. Pass it because I often forget to pass it. Oh, okay. Okay. Okay, let's go to another one here. Fernando is saying, don't use much salt. Okay, thank you. Good recommendation. Let's go to the next one here, which is this slide here, which I believe is another custom. That was past the salt. And then we go to this one here. Get that on full screen. Yes. So the next one, Leo, is in my country, it's normal to take A, one shower a day, two showers a day, three showers a day, less than one shower a day. And I'll start off. In Canada, you know this, or you know, like northern states, that in the winter time, sometimes we don't take a shower a day.
Okay.
And I don't know if you noticed that, you know, when you were working here, you know, like maybe some people like, oh.
Yeah, but here, you know, it's very hot. So we take at least one shower sometimes. Like in average, I take 2 showers a day.
2 showers a day. Yeah. And in your case, because you're a doctor, I mean, doctors are clean, right? They wear white and they're very clean people. So I understand. Yes. I remember that when I was living in your part of Brazil where you were.
Lived in Recife, so you right. know how hot it's here.
I used to take 3 showers a day.
There you go.
I mean, you take a shower in the morning, and by the time you get to work, you already need to take another shower. I remember. Let's see what other people are saying here. Pierre Plot from France is saying 2 showers a day in France. So I'm curious, Pierre, are you from the south of France? Yes. Salut, Pierre. Comment ça va? And Alfredo Guaman is saying, and he's in the USA. And he's saying that he takes a shower a day. Fernando's saying, when I wake up before the gym and after to sleep. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, there we go.
So we have different answers there for taking showers. But I will warn you that here in North America, it is possible in the wintertime that people, they just don't need to take a shower.
Yeah, that's really cold then.
Yeah. Like it's snowing, you know, when it's snowing outside and people don't sweat, they just get cold. They don't really need to take a shower. So, okay, let's go to the next one here. In my country, crosswalks are A, safe. I can cross with my eyes closed. let's just fix that there. It was a little off. I'll make it a little smaller. With my eyes closed. So that's the first one. If you can cross the street with your eyes closed. The second one is okay. Sometimes better to look first. Or C, dangerous. Never trust the drivers. Danger. Don't do it. Don't go. Yeah.
Well, in my experience, Vancouver is letter A. Like
oh, you think so? I was going to say letter B.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, maybe letter B, but I think it's more lean to letter A than B.
Okay.
But here it's letter C. You have to watch both sides before, even if if it's red for the driver, you should take care.
That so you can never be 100% sure. So
no.
So you have the signal, the walking signal. To cross, and it's a red light for them, but still, you're walking like...
Absolutely, yes.
I don't trust you, you know? Okay.
Look to your left or right and make sure there's no one coming in your direction.
Okay, yeah. Whereas in Canada, it's more like... I think it depends on the driver. You look at the driver, see, you know, kind of look in their eyes. But yeah, most of the time, people stop. That's true. I've never seen anybody get run over or something like that. Let's see what other... Shamir Francisco, where are you from, Shamir? It's too dangerous crosswalk in my country. Marvin Enriquez, too dangerous in my country. They are not careful. Dave Abraham, Kurdistan, same thing. You got to be careful. And Parvan Valizada... you have to look. Everybody's saying you have to look. But Pierre in France is saying in Marseille. So he's in Marseille. It's better to check the street before. Okay. Yeah. So everybody's saying be careful. All right. So let's go on to the next one. We're almost done. Yeah. Leo has a wedding to go to, folks.
Not mine.
No, not yours. No, it's not his, and it's not mine. The next one here is, I think it's one of the last ones. This one my wife and I were talking about, And I don't know if you have any experience, but in my country, it is common that if you are buying electronic devices, so if you're buying a TV, if you're buying a phone, if you're buying, you know, some electronic thing for your kitchen, in my country, A, you ask the sales clerk to open the box to see if the product is working. Or B, take the product home. If it doesn't work, take it back to the store.
Well, here, I think wherever I go, I do letter A because you save time. If it doesn't work, you don't have to come back to the store to change it. So it's better to double check in the store.
It sounds real practical. And when my wife arrived from Brazil the first time, she used to do that. Going into the store, she'd say, open, please. I want to see if it's working. And, you know, of course, here in North America, they're like, no, you take the product home. And if it doesn't work, you bring it back and we'll give you a new one. We'll exchange it. Yeah. And I don't know if you've ever had that experience, but that's kind of a North American thing, if the product's not working, then you take it back. But you can't force them to open the box at the store. My wife tried. She tried to train the people here in Canada, but it didn't work. Yeah. And I'm getting feedback here. I have Pierre from France saying that in France, if you don't, you don't have to try it before. Mm-hmm. In France, that means that you just take it home. Is that what you're saying, Pierre?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah. And, Solange from Brazil is saying, yeah, letter A, ask them to open the product and be sure that it's working. Mm-hmm. Eduardo, it's more common to check the product before taking it away. Aha. Yes. Dave Abraham, Kurdistan, we are testing the product in the store. Okay, so just in North America, we have this trust, this blind trust to just take the product home. Oh, yeah, it's going to work. Yeah, sometimes it doesn't, though. Sometimes it's broken. Anyway, Hank Scorpio, it depends. If it isn't the big appliance, we can try it at the store. But if it is a big one, definitely we try it at home. And if it doesn't work, we return it at the store to exchange it. Hmm. Okay. Yeah, where are you from, Hank? Yeah. Okay. And we're finishing off here. I think, let me just check here to see if we have any other pictures here. But it's great, everybody getting their feedback here. I have just one more. And this is something that I noticed with a difference. Actually, two more. So I'll go through them quickly. So everybody, including Leo, we have this one here. Is it cool to eat pizza with your hands in your country?
It's fine, but in Brazil, we eat with a knife and fork.
You eat with a knife and fork. So,
yeah.
And I know this, that if I eat pizza with my hands in Brazil, they're going to think that I'm impolite, like I'm a monkey, like, ooh, yeah. Right? It's not normal.
You know, but there is a trend here in Brazil, like there are some pizza place where they... if you ask for a knife and fork, they will give you, but normally there is only napkins like to eat the pizza.
Okay, so you're coming halfway and you're eating pizza with napkins. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm getting some other feedback here that Pierre in France is saying not at the restaurant with hands, but at home with hands, no problem. Okay, that's interesting. And then Lukman, who I think is in Iraq, is saying that you could eat it with your hands. Interesting. And okay. And I just have one more before we go. Aw. And that's this one here, Leo. And I don't think maybe I ever mentioned this one to you over the course of our lessons, which is this here. So I want you to imagine that you are at a friend's house. And they offer you some food, So I'm, you know, you come to my house and I say, hey, Leo, would you like to try this food that I made for you? And then in Canada, in the United States, the people, before they eat the food or try the food, they will smell the food. And it's not an insult. It's totally normal for somebody to, you know, it's good. To smell the food is okay. Yeah.
Well, that sounds odd to me.
Smelling food is not like if you're.
It's, yeah. Yeah, I think it's a bit impolite.
Or I think somebody might be offended by that. Don't you think?
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. They say, Steve, you know, I made this food for you, and I'm like, thanks. And then, what are you smelling the food for? Yeah. Anyway, so that was an interesting custom. Okay. And all right. Well, that's it for the live today. And we had lots of people. I want to thank Leo for participating in this. Leo's idea, as well as my idea next time, is that maybe Leo, if you want to talk a little bit about your profession, what you do. It would be interesting.
Yeah, maybe they'll be interesting about talking about hair loss. Let's see what people think about it.
Yeah, because in case everybody didn't know, Leo is a professional in the field of hair transplants and hair loss. Also in cosmetics?
Yes.
Yeah, in cosmetics.
Fillers and Botox.
Fillers and Botox. So I'm sure that we'll have lots of questions about that. And if you would like to join me on, if you want to follow all the updates for my videos and my website, you can join our live WhatsApp chat. And I will post that at the link below this video. I can actually post that later after I finish this video. And you can subscribe to my channel or you can watch more videos here. I will be releasing a new YouTube video soon. And yeah, I want to thank everybody for joining us. And Leo, maybe we'll be on YouTube live next Friday or something.
Absolutely.
Okay.
It's always a pleasure.
Okay, awesome. Well then, thank you very much, everybody. And bye for now.